Peter Carmit is a very dedicated researcher.
Inspiration for many people. Bright scientist. Made very important contributions to the field of angiogenesis in cancer. Peter is somebody who really likes to push boundaries.
He can give you a lot of comfort when you're doing well and when you want to achieve something.
C'est un chercheur pur sang, c'est comme un pitbull, il va dans un sens, il essaye de comprendre, et en fait où les autres lâchent parce qu'ils ne comprennent pas, lui il fonce, il va plus loin, il va plus profond, il essaye de comprendre ce que les autres ne comprennent pas.
Pitbull in the sense that once I am convinced of something, and I have a certain idea, I will grab it and go for it, that's correct. So angiogenesis is the formation of new blood vessels, and blood vessels are essential for the supply of oxygen and nutrients to every tissue, and that is why angiogenesis affects so many diseases. There are diseases that are promoted by angiogenesis, such as cancer or ocular blindness, blinding diseases. But there are also diseases that are the result of insufficient angiogenesis, such as a myocardial infarction or stroke. Cancer cells are always hungry, so because they grow so fast, they always need new food and oxygen, sugars and other nutrients. And that's why they stimulate the growth of new blood vessels, because they, when they attract them, then they also receive more of the oxygen and the nutrients and the sugars. And they do that in part, for instance, by secreting molecules like VEGF.
VEGF is a very important endothelial growth factor, so the factor that drives the proliferation and so on of blood vessel cells, of endothelial cells. And Peter also has made many important contributions in this field of VEGF.
The anti-VEGF therapy works in patients, but not as expected, as we had hoped. And that is why it is essential to develop new therapies. And that is why we actually changed completely the fields and start with something fundamentally different. And that is by focusing on metabolism. And so by targeting metabolic targets that are essential for new blood vessels to grow, one can actually inhibit the growth of new tumor blood vessels, and that is what we're focusing on now for the future. I can only say that I'm extremely grateful for the recognition. This is not only for me personally, but also for the entire crew, for the entire lab. They actually are doing all the work, so I feel very honored that I, in my person, can receive the award, but it's actually also for them. What we are now doing since the last 10 years is actually focus on what happens inside in the cell, and that is the process called metabolism. And metabolism converts actually is a process that converts nutrients to energy and biomass, building blocks, so that you can grow. And that turns out to be very insightful and also important. Because without energy, a cell cannot move. Without building blocks, a cell cannot grow and divide. And so that's the whole concept. We are targeting the engine, the metabolism, which is the engine of the cell, so that angiogenesis cannot occur anymore.
If you block these blood vessels too much, that the tumor actually becomes severely hypoxic, and that actually sometimes the cancer cells can escape the hypoxia. And so what Peter has now been doing in the last years is not to only block this growth of blood vessels, but to actually normalize the blood vessels.
And if you can normalize the morphology of the blood vessels inside the tumor, then you can much better apply, for example, chemotherapy towards the tumor. It will much better go into the tumor.
That will help to improve other treatments, such as, for instance, chemotherapy or other targeted therapies or immunotherapy. Because one of the goals that we try to achieve is actually to normalize the abnormal tumor blood vessels so that the immunotherapeutics and the chemotherapeutics reach better the cancer cells. And thereby we will actually reduce metastasis and improve the efficacy. You have to be a dreamer. You need to have hope for the future. And I really believe very strongly in new ideas and that you have to go for it. I try to give that message also to young people who work with me, is that they really have to believe in themselves and in good ideas.